type of the wrong, all type of shit.
Natural selection and the favored human races. Did you know that today they only report half the title that Charles Darwin wrote? His title had to do with favored human races, assigning supremacy.
Hey, sexy.
Damn, what time did y'all go? Yeah, that's kind of late.
Wasup, it's phenomenal, but I'm going through a rebirth. Is the new promo out yet?
Where the computer at? Did I move him? No, right here.
I'm selling Jokic for 29K, 6K profit if you wanna snipe.
I didn't see it. Selling Jokers for 29K, 6K profit if you want to snipe. Is the new promo out yet? Nah, not yet. What's up, Phenom? That's what I'm waiting for, though. That's what I'm waiting for, that new promo. Matter of fact, hold on. I don't know why they take so long to drop this stuff. Just the update. Yep. Jokic for 29K. What Jokic? The pink diamond? Jokic, you talking about the pink diamond? I don't know if I want to play I don't never play that shit. Try to make some MT, but fuck it. I don't feel like trying to make no damn MT. That shit's only like, tell you what time it is, though. Time to wake and bake. Turn that bathroom light on. Turn that light off for me. It's phenomenal, but I'm going through a rebirth. Phenomenal wrestling. Is the new promo out yet? No. Something different on the slug. I need a new torch. Damn it. We just waiting for these new spotlights, man. Or whatever they about to drop. Anything y'all want to see, let me know. We can go to it. I'm just chilling. It's 6 o'clock in the morning where I'm at.
You're a man. Most name brand bars and body washes, you...
Shout out to Dane Calloway.
Log on to patreon.com/Dane Calloway or paypal.me/Dane Calloway to support me, my channel, and my content. Merchandise is... Log on to patreon.com/Dane Calloway or paypal.me/Dane Calloway to support me, my channel, and my content. Merchandise is now available at imjustheretomakeyouthink.com.
I want that Joker.
I want that Joker. Oh yeah, old boy selling it. Old boy Sally selling it for 29. 29.99
Sort of looks familiar, and so you had
29.99
Now, there are many truths that lay dormant behind the original meaning of words.
I got 30K on me, RN.
Essential key factor when you are progressing in perpetual divine oneness.
Hit that like button, K.
The best new thing since sliced bread. The 5G network is said to be more than 100 times faster than the 4th-gen network, in which 4G is just limited to using frequencies directed from a single cell tower. That's within a 10 to 20 mile radius.
You off today?
I'm off today.
Additionally,
I got 30K on me.
The frequencies to work more proficient and uninterrupted. However, having all of these frequencies working all at once comes with a hefty price tag, and I am not referring to how much your internet service provider would charge you, nor how much the installation would cost them. With more frequency waves being emitted, whether higher or lower, comes even more radiation, much, much more radiation, to a point where scientists, doctors, activists, physicians, and even professors in the medical field have publicly stated their concerns
nice
for this 5G network and its immediate health hazards towards any living being. For example, a public health professor at the University of California named Dr. Joel Moskowitz stated, quote, "The deployment of 5G or fifth generation cellular technology constitutes a massive experiment on the health of all species because millimeter waves are weaker than microwaves. They are predominantly absorbed by the skin, meaning their distribution is quite focused there. Since skin contains capillaries and nerve endings, millimeter waves' bioeffects may be transmitted through molecular mechanisms by the skin or through the nervous system." End quote. Then he also said that the millimeter waves especially our homes, making the rate of being exposed to RF radiation even higher. Kevin Modis, who is the president of the U.S. Brain Tumor Association, said that, quote, within the radio frequency portion of the electromagnetic spectrum, the higher the frequency, the more dangerous the radiation is, end quote. Studies have shown that being exposed to these types of radio waves or radio frequencies, whether
Miles Bridges is retarded,
can cause brain damage, cancer, and even affect an infant's DNA structure tremendously. Now, the good news is, there is a fight to stop this systematic installation of the 5G network, and the FCC, or the Federal Communications Commission, is fully aware of the public's concerns. But so far, it just delayed the process of installation. And I am doing my part by making you aware of what's going on. Spread the word, people. So now, which definition of the word smart correlates with their intentions? Wait, before you answer that, let's go over another alarming concern in regards to these smart devices. Most of you are aware that when you are utilizing, let's say, your smartphone, for example, that your direct location is being recorded, even if you have your locator off on your device. You can actually check this for yourself by just simply having your locator off and type in google.com in your web browser, for example, and scroll all the way down to the bottom of that initial page, and you'll see what I mean. The reason why this is happening is due to your map that is automatically assigned to your specific internet service. This is also how those ads that you may see anywhere you surf the web is being catered to you based on your location and your browsing activity. Yeah, that gets recorded too. Oh, and let's not forget.
This is a brief history of B&H, everyone's favorite photo and video store. The year was 1973. The Mets went to the World Series.
Forget about how you just had a conversation with your friend about possibly buying some new items you wanted or needed. And then not long after that, you'll see an ad for that particular item pop up all of a sudden while you're surfing the web. That's because your conversations are also being softly recorded by your smartphone or any other smart device that has a built-in microphone for that matter. Now, you're probably asking, is this even legal? Yes and no, but more so yes, due to you nonchalantly agreeing and accepting the terms of service and privacy policies of free websites like Facebook and Google, and free applications like Instagram and Twitter, and even those violent face manipulation apps that people download on their smart devices. If you didn't know this, be sure to make it a habit to read the privacy policies and even the permissions that you literally give them inadvertently. Now, with all of that being said, the alternative to combat these smart device privacy issues is a service called VPN, which is an acronym for Virtual Private Network. Having a VPN can allow its users to surf the internet privately, safely, and more secure. In more broader terms, having a VPN allows the user to hide their IP addresses from unwanted people, like, say, for example, advertisers, scammers, hackers, and even the government if applicable. Hiding your IP address is not illegal, just in case you were wondering. In fact, your IP address is automatically assigned to you by your internet service provider, like Verizon, AT&T, Comcast, or Spectrum, just to name a few. Your IP address tends to showcase your direct location, whether if you're at home, at work, or on the road, depending. that time. And in most cases,
what are you doing, bro? You quit?
Have no idea that their every move is being tracked.
Just quit.
Not only by their internet service provider, but anyone else that decides to take a peek at your activity for whatever reason. The best thing about having a VPN service is that you can stay anonymous for as long as you own the service. Because a VPN service
foul.
Love my ass up, yeah. He mad. Look at this nigga, man. The fuck. He big mad. Chauncey over here, works. Chauncey over here, strap. Chauncey said, man, get the strap. He fought that so hard, bro. Like, he really, really. Yeah, bro. Go. Bye bye.
Amy Shack overpowered.
Assumptions or opinions in any sense.
Amy Shack is definitely overpowered.
So, with all of that being said,
he nice.
Let's begin this segment with
not to see how much he go for. Fuck a sell him.
And that is,
he just go for stupid ass cheap. There was so many of them, I guess.
Inside the fire. lets you thwart those annoying
fuck, I'm selling for three. They don't sell, that's on them. They sell. I'm not gonna lowball myself. Fuck that shit. I need all mine. I need all mine.
All these phones and masking the number that displays on the caller ID.
You can make it come from whatever number you want.
Any number I choose.
Okay, so we have a couple of dozen phones here. These are from our NBC colleagues. I literally just walked around the office and said,
shut up.
According to the 1828 Webster's English Language Dictionary, it defines the word believe as, quote, a persuasion of the truth. Further stating that believe is, quote, a word that is used for persuasion or opinion when the evidence is not so clear as to leave no doubt. But the shades of strength in opinion can hardly be defined or exemplified, hence the use of qualifying words as a firm, full, or strong belief. End quote. Now, this is very essential to note when decoding any and all presented information that was given to you as if it is truthful, because the term persuasion has a manipulative construct that is typically not based on any logical grounds or even empirical evidence for that matter. According to the sixth edition of the book entitled Persuasion, Social Influence and Compliance Gaining, authors Robert Gass and John Zeter stated that the term persuasion is, quote, an attempt to influence a person's beliefs, attitudes, intentions, motivations, or behaviors. So if the term persuasion also carries a negative connotation when referring to the English definition of the word belief, then that should make you question if what you were taught to believe in, especially if it's not yourself, carries a malevolent side to the story that is simultaneously promoted as the greatest influence in your life, regardless if any hard evidence is present or not. So my original question can be simply answered by the process of elimination, but I am aware that some of you may have a hard time digesting information versus what you are traditionally accustomed to hearing, and that's fine. So let's take a deeper dive down the rabbit hole, shall we? Some people would state that the term Moor was another word for black, and it refers to black people or African people. But here's the problem with that. There is absolutely no hard evidence that exists today that would support this heavily campaigned theory. In fact, the term Moor was vaguely used historically, and when it was done so in a descriptive sense, referring to a person predominantly of the Muslim faith, or even Christian faith later on, that has a dark hue of complexion and resides throughout the surrounding lands nearest the Mediterranean Sea, and so forth. What is very important to note here is that dark does not necessarily mean that a person's skin complexion is literally black in color. It simply describes a person's hue as being different shades in color, which is realistically various shades of the color brown. The term Moor does not refer to just one common racial group of people of a particular country or continent, or even one particular culture for that matter. The origin of
kind of want to
buy only this form of spelling can be traced back to one of the many lingua francas that still exist today. In my previous documentary called What Language Was Used Before English Existed, I mentioned that a lingua franca takes many words and their meanings or ideas and reduces them into a simplified version that could be understood by many.
New promo up yet?
No promo up yet. Not yet. Not yet. I guess I'll get the update though. But I'm going to be on. I'm going to be right here with it. Soon as it pop out. So does Shaquille. Nice. Ah, if I can sell another one.
Let's take a look at the so-called history of language and how it became what it is today. Now, there are some people who would equate language and its creation to the Phoenicians, due to the many stories of these same said people being the actual creators of the alphabet. According to the Encyclopedia of Trade from Ancient Times to Present, most of the world's writing systems before the invention of the alphabet were pictograms, such as the Egyptian hieroglyphics. An alphabet is an important cultural innovation that allows easy and therefore potential mass literacy, more accurate record and contract keeping, adaptability to new intellectual concepts, and thus accelerated cultural change. The Greek, Latin, Hebrew, Arabic, and Cyrillic alphabets all derived ultimately from the Phoenician, end quote. But what is very important to note here is that it also states that the Phoenicians are the ancestors to which all Western alphabets can be traced, but it is not the ancestor of all languages. And that is because an alphabet does not produce the language. It only provides a symbol for the oral sound that a person makes when speaking a particular language. The word language is derived from the Latin word lingua, which means the tongue.
That's some deep shit.
I think he'll get he'll continue to play in the National Football League. And as something comes up, he'll have an opportunity maybe to be a starter. But because there's this stain on him, people aren't really going to give him a fair shot. They just,
what's
know,
the stain, though?
This is the part I don't get. The stain on him is, but the stain is he didn't do anything to earn starting spots at either one of those two stops.
I hear that.
That's, but in the NFL, they look at that and go, well, he couldn't get none out
of it. Do they not? Does nobody in the NFL understand context? Because the context is that he was taken in Arizona, who was dreadful, so bad that they fired the coach after 1 year. You just said that the offensive line talent there was so bad that to do anything there was virtually impossible. He goes to Miami, which is more or less the exact same thing,
right,
just on the other side.
But you know how when you don't give them any hope, Danny Dimes made you feel like at least he gave you one or two games where he was like, oh, man, he got named Danny Dimes now. Josh Rosen played in a handful of games, and he gave you nothing. And that's what they look at. They look at that, oh, he didn't give us anything. With Danny Dimes, it's like, oh, he got a shot. Oh, my God. And you see how they build him up.
They did build him up. But to Travis's point, context is everything.
No, I get it. But I'm just telling you the thought and the mindset of these execs in the NFL is that they don't want to be the first. They like,
clearly.
They like, no, we don't want to be that.
There's not a lot of forward thinkers.
Dude, watch, he's going to end up in New England when it rains and
but
stuff.
But there's the guy that
right?
is not, that he, if anybody's going to understand the context,
yeah.
It's that dude.
He's like, I'm going to send you a 6-round pick for Josh Rosen. They're like, okay, because he's trash.
Let me ask y'all something, though. Why do you feel that way?
Because that's just what Bill does.
No, Bill doesn't do that. That's not, people get it twisted. When Bill get Corey Dillon was balling in Cincinnati. Everybody make it seem like Corey Dillon was garbage in Cincinnati, and Bill got him and turned his career around.
He's like, no. He gave Tim Tebow a shot.
No, he can't. Josh McDaniel was on the staff who drafted him in Denver and brought him there just to be around and have a body for Cam. That ain't a real shot.
What Bill Belichick has been really good at, put Tom Brady in a separate category. All the other guys he's brought in, with Brian Mallett's an exception, Brian Hoyer went on to start somewhere else.
Mm-hmm.
Teddy Brissett goes on to start somewhere else.
Mm-hmm.
Jimmy Garoppolo goes on to start somewhere else.
Mm-hmm.
Matt Castle goes on to start somewhere else.
Mm-hmm.
He's been able to identify a lot of backup quarterbacks and get them starting gigs other places.
Backup quarterbacks who were thought to be garbage.
Right.
And next thing you know, not only do they get paid.
All I'm going to say to that before we move on is everybody y'all just named wasn't very good at the next spots.
They just wasn't.
G was just in the Super Bowl.
Yeah, but come on, man. They talking about getting rid of Jimmy G already.
Who?
And there's so many people talking about getting... The San Francisco people are saying get rid of Jimmy G. Because when it was 30-15, guess what the Kansas City Chiefs did? They let Patrick Mahomes throw. When it was 30-15, they turned around and handed the ball off.
All right, so...
with Jimmy Garoppolo.
The NFL owners and the NFL Players Association...
snap your fingers.
They are getting ready to sign off on a new CBA that would change a whole bunch of things in the NFL. If you hear Adam Schefter tell it, this is a money play for both sides.
We're going to get more regular season weeks. We're going to get more postseason games, more wild card action. And what do the players get? An increase in their percent of the revenue. Now, right now, the NFL players get 47% of the current revenue under the terms of the new deal. It will be 48% for 16 games and 48.5% for a 17-game season, which means a shift of $5 billion. That's five with a B, billion dollars. So the players get a lot more money. The NFL gets more games to sell, which equals more money. And basically, there's more money for everybody to go around.
Here, look, the $5 billion is why this is going to get done. The player pool gets $5 billion more dollars. They're going to sign off on it. I mean, that's a pretty easy math equation. The part that affects us, the part that affects football fans, is the 17th regular season game and the addition of a 7th playoff team in each conference. And look, there are some small downsides, but generally speaking, Keith, both of these feel like a huge win. That the number one seed now becomes more valuable, and the playoff road to get to the Super Bowl for the rest of the 2-7 gets a little more challenging.
And that's a good thing, though. I don't mind the competitive nature in which they have now are talking about assembling, which is playoff format, which is 17 games in the regular season minus the one game, moving it down in the preseason to 3 instead of 4. Economically, it doesn't change much other than on the positive side, nothing on the negative. And on top of that, there's a lot of more benefits for players, former players. There's a lot more everything in this new potential CBA format that the contract that they're going to put together. Hopefully, the deal gets done. And if I'm anybody that's in free agency right now, I'm wishing and hoping that this deal gets done before the start of free agency, because now it goes into the entire pool, and now I get a piece of that $5 billion sooner rather than later.
Yeah, no, the money part works out. I want to read you some numbers. Here are the percentages of getting to the Super Bowl, okay, from the way we've had it previously with six seeds, okay? If you're the number one seed, you got a 51% chance of getting the Super Bowl. So basically, it's coin flip. That's a really good odds, right? You're the number one. So we assume that stays the same. The number one seed becomes valuable. The number two is pretty good. It's nearly 28%, 27.5%.
Waiting on the promos. Waiting on the promos. Oh, shit.
And I got a 1-4 shot. That's pretty good. After that, it falls off a cliff. The number three is about 3.5%. The number four, oddly, is a little bit higher than that at 12%. And then the five is at just under 2%. And the six is at just over 3. So we're talking single digits other than the four, which is just barely into the double digits. Now, all of a sudden, if you're the one, I got a 50-50 shot at this thing, and everybody else. And the reason number two is 27, because they don't have to play that extra game. There's one less chance to have a bad day.
Yeah.
Now, all of a sudden, they're in that pool. It's a really good, exciting look.
And think about well, the way the format is scheduled now. One of the first things that you talk about is we want to be the one of the two seed. We want to be one of the two seed.
Want to be at home on Wild Card Weekend.
Now you go in there, it's like, man, we gotta be the one seed, dog. We need the extra rest. We need to just chill and all those sort of things. So it's going to be competitive, ultra competitive, come the regular season. That week 16, 17, 15 in football is going to be big time.
Absolutely.
Listen, more football, more money, more joy. Let's just be real with it. We can't get so caught up that we forget that this is entertainment. So all the NFL is proposing is one more Avengers movie. What they're proposing is one more concert. What they're proposing is one more 3-hour window in which we get to, like, have great conversations and a debate and blah, 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 blah. And I think that's fantastic. But from a pure football perspective, I don't like the idea that a number two seed now gets punished.
Significantly.
Because they're getting punished.
Yeah.
It's like, oh, you lost that one game, and now you're two seed? You'll fall all the way down here with the other guys.
But to Key's point, it makes those 17 regular seasons. And because one of the things that makes the NFL so much better than the other two sports is that the regular season is so much more meaningful. The Lakers are going to play 82 games. The Dodgers are going to play 162. And one out of 162 is statistically irrelevant. You know, in the NBA, it's not much more relevant. One out of 17 matters a great deal. And now all of a sudden, we're talking about being at home and not playing or getting that first-round bye. It's huge. The argument that you hear, Key, against some of this is now all of a sudden, if you add a seventh team, you're going to add a bunch of bad teams. It's not true.
Not true at all.
Go back and look at it. We went back about 10 years. There wouldn't have been one sub-500 team that wasn't a division winner. And they're going anyway. They were in the division, so they're in anyway. Those teams that are in that seventh spot are either at 500 or better. So this idea you're letting in the dregs of the NFL, it's just not true.
The only other rule I would like to see adjusted since they're tweaking things is that if you are a sucky, and I said that word correctly, division winner, you don't get to host no playoff game against someone with a better record. Like, reseed the whole thing. It's like, you get in, man, that's fine and dandy. But if you're 8-8 and you won the NFC East or something like that, you don't get to host a 12-win team.
Okay, so that, but they still get in, right?
You still get in. Yeah, you reseed the whole thing.
What do you think? Okay, do you like that idea that division winners still qualify, but you do not automatically, because right now, if you win the division, you host a playoff game.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, right, under LZ's format, you still get in, but we're going to reseed based on record.
Let's look at the 2010 Seahawks. They won the division at 7-9. They should be hosting nothing.
And they won.
I kind of think that if you don't win the division, you should obviously be on the road. But your record at 7-9, you know, they won a division at 7-9. I think LZ has a point. At 7-9, but at 7-9, I'm not really, you know. But you did win your division, right?
Yes, you get in.
But the division, yeah, I know, but you got a home playoff game. So your division is bad.
Here, I'm knighting you. You are now the commissioner of the NFL. Do you do it or not? Do you put the division winner on the road because they have a worse record than a wild card qualifier?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
And can we get Kaepernick back in?
I've already told you.
Hey, man, my brother.
877.
I'm sorry to do you that way, but I'm a little tired of Kaepernick.
877.
The hash go, man.
710 ESPN. Do you like the potential for it? They still have to sign on it. It seems likely that it's going to go because the owners are getting what they want. They get more playoff games, which means more money. The players are getting more money as well. Do you like the idea of adding a seventh playoff team on each side? This baseball. It's only when we get into September where there's a limited amount of games and we're really paying attention where we start thinking that these games matter because it's less than 1% of the game every night.
Yeah, I mean, the more you have, the less the demand. And when you expand 17 games in a season, you water it down just by a fraction. Let's not, hopefully next season they won't go, hey, let's do 20.
No, that's, now we're getting to that point where I can take a, I can skip one.
It's a slippery slope, my friend.
I can skip one. All right. Are the Clippers deeper than the Lakers? A very important voice in Lakerland says yes. We'll tell you who it is. That's coming up next on the morning show at 710 ESPN.
Your city, your station, on your duties on 710 ESPN.
You know when you gotta be somewhere, it's like really urgent. You don't want to do it over the phone. Some things just can't be said with an LOL or an OMG. Some things just need to be done IRL. So you're getting your Nissan Altima and drive. Feel the VC turbo engine instantly react to give you more power and efficiency so you can get where you need to go.
Hey, Eric. What are you doing here?
Like.
Huh?
Your social post. I liked it.
Oh, thank you. You know, there's a button for that, right?
I do.
The Nissan Altima, now offering the most tech-advanced engine in its class. This is tech that helps you be there. This is Nissan Intelligent Mobility. Auto-Pacific segmentation. 2020 Altima Platinum versus latest in-market competitors in the premium midsize class. Available feature. World's first production variable compression turbo engine launched by Nissan Motor Company Limited in 2018.
Slam Jam Man, baby!
Hey, Dick, what are you doing? Warming up for the game?
I call all the games I watch, even when I can't get tickets. It helps bring that stadium atmosphere to wherever I watch it from. Oh, the type of Danny does it again.
Come on, Dick, save it for the air. We've got a game. And check out Vivid Seats. It's the easiest way to get all the tickets to the games you want to go to.
Vivid Seats for the win, baby. Vivid Seats.
Hiring can be a challenge. As Quotable co-founder Gretchen Huebner discovered, Gretchen needed to hire a game artist for her education tech company, so she went to ZipRecruiter.com, posted her job, and found the right person in less than 2 weeks. How? ZipRecruiter's technology finds people with the right experience and invites them to apply to your job. It's no wonder. 4 to 5 employers who post on ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate within the first day. ZipRecruiter, the smartest way to hire. And right now, try ZipRecruiter for free at our web address, ZipRecruiter.com/Dan. That's ZipRecruiter.com/DAN.
Stopped by the cops? I'm attorney Darren Cavanoghi from 1-800-NO-CUFFS. If the cuffs go on and you've got only one call to make, you better make it count. 1-800-NO-CUFFS, the leader in criminal defense. Because no one looks good in handcuffs, unless you're into that sort of thing. 1-800-NO-CUFFS.
The Home Depot has a secret recipe for new kitchen appliances. Up to 40% off appliance special buys. Like a stainless steel Whirlpool kitchen package for only $18.98. You get a side-by-side refrigerator, electric range, dishwasher, microwave, and for a limited time, over $1,000 off. Guess the secret's out. how doers get more done. U.S. only gas extra. See store for details. Valid through February 26th.
I have to go to the gym and untangle my headphones while warming up on the treadmill. And I'll finally untangle them 4 miles later, at which point I'm gonna be real tired! Oh, yeah!
Motorcycles make everything exciting. And when Geico makes it easy to switch and save on motorcycle insurance, it's even more exciting.
And once I put my headphones in, I'll realize my phone's dead! Then I get to run in silence!
Geico Motorcycle. 15 minutes could save you 50% or more.
My portfolio's diversified, my 401k's maxed, but my savings account just sat there till I switched it to Marcus by Goldman Sachs. I'm earning way more now, just between you and me. My savings are right on track, it's like I got upgraded for free.
You can, money. With an online savings account from Marcus by Goldman Sachs, you can earn much more interest than with the largest banks. Sign up at Marcus.com.
Comparison made to the three largest U.S. banks measured by total deposits. Rates as of January 21st, 2020 may vary by state. Goldman Sachs Bank USA, member FDIC.
Saving is easy with Spectrum Mobile. Unlike other providers, you can actually mix and match our unlimited and buy the gig data plans so you can build the perfect family plan. Unlimited nationwide talk and text is always included. See for yourself with the Spectrum Mobile Savings Calculator. Go to SpectrumMobile.com/save and see how you could save up to 40% or more. Plus, you can change plans without penalty, and there are no added taxes, fees, or contracts. Visit SpectrumMobile.com/save. Restrictions apply. Check for details.
Don't ignore your check engine light. Stop by O'Reilly and get your vehicle scanned free of charge. O'Reilly Auto Parts. Better parts, better prices every day.
Oh, 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 O'Reilly Auto Parts.
Keyshawn Johnson and his fellas wake you up from 6 to 10 a.m. Your morning show.
710 ESPN.
On 710 ESPN.
We're going to get to that in just 1 second. Who says yes to that might surprise you. But very quickly, we're talking about the NFL playoff format changes, potential changes at least. Let's go to the Sprint People's Hotline in Orange County and Mark. Mark, you're on the morning show. What's up?
Hey, morning, fellas. Got a good idea. I think you have the second half of the season, keep the standings there, and then make that team the seventh seed. And then obviously, if that team already qualifies, you work your way down that list.
Wait, I'm not sure I'm following.
Say it again?
Well, you take the second half of the year, the last 8 games, you keep the record there. The team with the best record gets that wild card spot. If they're already a team that qualified, you work down that list in the second half. I mean, this stimulates trade deadline. This gets teams a fresh start mid-season.
That'd mess up everybody's fantasy football.
The idea isn't to incentivize the regular season and break it into two halves, because right. The NFL regular season is already a smash hit. This is more of a playoff tweak more than anything. And let's use the Rams again very quickly. The Rams, under this plan, the Rams would have qualified last year. They would have been the seventh seed. They would have played the two in the NFC, which under those would have been Green Bay. You don't think that the Rams absolute, now they might not have, but I guarantee you Green Bay would not have wanted to see that Rams team coming in, because if they have a good night, they're going to score 40 points and you lose.
But now the Rams' record's not as good. It's not as good as Green Bay's. So they go to Green Bay.
They would go to Green Bay.
And their golf struggle is
not great. But the idea of the Rams having a good day against anybody, there's not a team in the league that the Rams go play and say they have no shot. There's not one team that's out there. I don't care if it was the Chiefs or the Ravens or anybody. They can beat anybody. Now,
you know what's crazy?
No, that's true. That's very true. And the Rams certainly would have qualified and been one of those teams that would have given some people some nightmares, game planning and staying up to try to figure out how to slow them down.
Let's try one more. L.A. on the Sprint People's Hotline. And James. James, you're up next. What's going on?
Good morning, guys.
What up, Jay?
I love the new format, but the only thing they got to change, because I'm a 49er fan, and last year they had their bye like at week four, and then they had to go, 12 weeks straight without a bye. So they have to. Imagine if you're that, especially like the last game where it was like between Seattle and 49ers, they had to if they lost that game, that would have been, 13, 14 weeks straight, no rest or anything like that. If I was a player, and they're trying to say player safety, that was one thing I would challenge.
You know what's funny about the byes is, doing the bye week, man, you never just sit at home and do nothing anyway. I mean, people are like, oh, man, way. So you're not just like, I got 7 days to just do nothing.
Sit in the tub.
Sit in the tub and just do nothing. No, that's not true. You hopping on planes, you going to partying, you working out. Our buys were weird, man, because one of the things during our bye week, you still had 2 to 3 days of practice. So what would happen is, let's say, for instance, a regular normal week.
Okay.
So on a Sunday, we play.
Yep, you win.
You win.
Yay!
You come in on Monday.
Yay! Okay, right.
And on a bye week, you're in on a Monday?
Yeah, on a Monday. You come in, you watch Sunday's film. You're off automatically on Tuesday. We're going to practice you on Wednesday, Thursday. Come in early Friday. Get out early. So you
get a bye week. You don't have a game. You still got
exactly my point. So Friday, you come in, go out early. If you don't learn what your off days are until Thursday or Friday, so you don't have time to do it, book anything, and then they want you back Monday morning for meetings and stuff and light workout before the college. That's
Bill's
the game, though, man. No, that was everybody.
All right, get the most out of your tax refund and get a great phone. Stop by a Sprint store today and learn how you can get a Samsung Galaxy X10 for an amazing price. Get a network built for unlimited and a great price at Sprint. Visit your local Sprint store, Sprint.com, or call 800-SPRINT-1 to learn more. Restrictions apply.
Hey, Coach, when is the bye day? Well, you don't know. He hasn't told y'all. You can get the little young assistant. Man, I don't know. He ain't told us either.
All right. So we've been talking about the Lakers and the Clippers and the depth issue between those two teams. Magic Johnson, of all people, is conceding that the Clippers have better depth. What he said was, if you look at it man for man, the Clippers are probably better than the Lakers in terms of the bench. Okay, he went on to say, with Anthony Davis and LeBron James, to me, they're going to be the key, and they're going to have to dominate in that series. Then we're going to need that third score. This is what we know, right? That if this comes down to who's got the best eighth, and ninth guy, the Lakers
Let's
are
go, baby, baby, baby.
Really it comes down to who's got the two best, and maybe that third guy is the issue.
It is, and the Lakers are certainly a team that felt like at the beginning of the season that Kuz could potentially emerge into that third scoring guy, but he hasn't really given them on a consistent basis what they were looking for. So they kicked the tires before the trade deadline to find the guy. They didn't get a chance to acquire. So now I think they run it by committee. Who gets the hot hand? Who's there as a hot hand guy that becomes our third guy? Because what we're depending on is our two top frontline guys to play long minutes and give us the consistency in the games. They've been giving us a consistency in the regular season. So therefore, when we sit them down, we're not like far behind, or we feeling like they got to stay on the floor the majority of the night. I think that when you start talking about Green and Dwight and Rondo and Bradley and KCP, we got to kind of do that by committee as that third guy.
Kelsey, do you think that the committee works? Can you go into series by series saying, okay, I got my three or whatever it is, or my two in the Lakers case, and I'll figure it out game by game, series by series, or do they need to iron out these things before they get into the playoffs?
I just did a quick search on field goal attempts. Chris Bosh, even with LeBron James, was still getting like 15 field goal attempts, blah, 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 to help make sure that he was contributing. Kyle Kuzma field goal attempts dropped from 15.5 to 10.6 since a season ago.
Mm-hmm.
Five less shot attempts, and he's giving you six less points. That makes sense. If you want more scoring from your third guy, it would appear you need to give your third guy some more shots. I'm not sure why he's not getting these opportunities, and I can go back and do the same thing to Kevin Love, but it just appears to me that in some ways, we're punishing Kyle Kuzma for not being the guy we need without giving him enough attempts to show he can be the guy we need.
Well, okay.
Five less shots is huge.
They may have already made that decision. You may have explained why he's not scoring like that, but we go back to that final game before the All-Star break against Denver's, an overtime game against the number two seed, a team that you might very well see in the playoffs,
mm-hmm.
and through the final part of the fourth quarter and all of overtime, Kyle Kuzma wasn't even on the court.
No, he wasn't, because he, to his detriment, still at times struggled to figure out how to be impactful while I'm still on the floor not getting touches. Again, the Chris Bosh example. yeah, he was getting his touches, but he was also making sure he did other things too, so when he had stretches in which he didn't touch the ball, he could still be a contributor. Kyle Kuzma has been trying this new thing, guys, where the shot goes up and yellow he kind of darts it, and he darts it to the paint looking for offensive rebounds. Now, he's had some success with that, but the problem, of course, is that that allows your man to leak out in case you can't get that offensive rebound.
Keith, tell me this. How important is it for you as an athlete to know what you're going to be asked to do before the game even starts, to know that this is what my role is on this team, and it's not predicated necessarily on what's happening at the end of the game, that this is what they're going to ask me to do? How important?
It's important, but you learn that and know that before the game anyway. Like, you know what you're doing. He knows what they're asking him. You don't go into a game and you don't know what you're supposed to do. But what you can do is go into a game and think this is what you're going to do. But then once you get in it, it changes.
Right.
That happens all the time. And it changes when you're sitting there and all of a sudden you think you're going to get 25 minutes and you're sitting there and they look at you and go, LZ, come on. And you're sitting there and you're going, well, that's not what we talked about on Thursday. And then you're sitting, you go, and then they finally put you in and you're like, man, this dude, that can mess with your mind.
All right, so we know that the Astros have gotten off pretty easily. We're all going to get to be commissioner for a day and punish the Astros.
Yes.
What are you going to do to make it right in baseball? That's coming up next on The Morning Show, 710 ESPN.
Mason in Ireland, the show where it's all happening.
Okay, I've complained before. I'm going to complain again.
About
can
what?
Can we get rid of the word fellas? I can't stand the word what? Fellas. I feel like it's like 1973. Fellas.
Made up.
No, it's not. No, fellas. Nobody says fellas. No, who says? When was the last time you used the word fellas? Hey,
yesterday.
Fellas.
Literally.
No, you did not.
Mason and Ireland, coming up this afternoon at 3.
710 ESPN.
This month, we celebrate National Battery Day, so remember to get your vehicle's battery tested for free at Advance Auto Parts. If it needs to be replaced, we have batteries starting at just $79.99. And the best part, installation is free. Plus, Speed Perks members get 500 bonus Speed Perks points when you purchase a gold or platinum battery until February 26th. Think ahead. Think Advance. At Advance Auto Parts and participating Carquest locations. Free installation with purchase, most vehicles, most locations.
It's time for some straight talk. You know what a full-court press is in basketball, right? Full defensive coverage with no holes. Well, that's the kind of coverage you get with Straight Talk Wireless. It runs on America's best 4G LTE networks, same as the big carriers, but just for a lot less. Just $45 a month gets you the unlimited plan with 25 gigs of high-speed data, then 2G, saving you up to half the cost of the big carriers. No contract. Full-court coverage, half the cost. Straight Talk Wireless. Everything for less. Savings may vary. See terms and conditions at straighttalk.com.
Hello, ESPN LA. Nick Cardin here from Puente Hills Toyota, the house of yes. Great news. We've just partnered up with Kelley Blue Book to become an official buying center for your current vehicle, and we're prepared to make you an instant cash offer. You can either walk away with the money or simply have it go towards the purchase or lease of a new Toyota, or choose a pre-owned vehicle from our massive inventory. Either way, when you come to Puente Hills Toyota, you'll walk away with a peace of mind that you've chosen the right place.
Individual rates, coverage offerings, and savings may vary. Subject to terms and conditions, not available in all areas.
If you run a small business, you
know that Zoe, you ready?
Workers' comp insurance can be tedious and costly. But
dress
insurance is changing that, and founder John Swigert is here with me to tell us how.
At Pi, we saw that small businesses needed a better way to handle their workers' comp coverage. So we built Pi Insurance from the ground up for them. We make getting workers' comp a no-brainer with simple online shopping. Best of all, we're helping them save up to 30%.
And the reviews say it all.
That's right. Pi Insurance is rated excellent on Trustpilot by our customers. They tell us we're fast, affordable, and easy to work with.
Thanks, John. Bottom line here is that if you run a small business, you can say goodbye to expensive, complicated workers' comp and discover the next generation of small business insurance. So why don't you see if Pi can save you up to 30%? Check your rate today at PIEinsurance.com. That's PIEinsurance.com.
Act driven, born to be Carl Jacob and Ronnie. Carl Jacob.
Jacob and Ronnie, there's complicated stuff out there right now. Like, for example, Uber, Lyft. And this is one area that
it's growing like crazy, and you've jumped in a big way.
I think the Uber and Lyft phenomenon has been great, but then from the other side, it has created a lot of problems.
And they must know then, because you've done so many of these cases, that when they see your name, it's time to get down to business.
They understand that our clients get the best medical care. They understand that our clients see the best doctors available to them in that area. Insurance companies try to find mistakes that an attorney or the injured client makes in order to use that against them. We do our best to make sure that, you know, every mistake that an insurance company believes can be used in their advantage is actually eliminated, holding them in the corner to have to pay our client what's just and what's fair.
Call Jacob, 844-24-JACOB. That's 844-24-JACOB, or calljacob.com.
Call Jacob.
Hey guys, Mike Golic here. Athletes are still athletes when they're off the field. That's why they still need to make good choices, like staying hydrated with Bolt 24. With antioxidant vitamins A and C, electrolytes from watermelon and sea salt, and no artificial sweeteners or flavors. Bolt 24 is all-day hydration for all-day athletes. It's available in delicious flavors like watermelon, strawberry, tropical mango, and mixed berry. And can be found in the sports drink aisle at most major retailers. Bolt 24, all-day hydration.
Keyshawn Johnson and his fellas wake you up from 6 to 10 a.m. Your morning show.
710 ESPN.
On 710 ESPN.
Look out for the cheetah!
This is their I Love L.A. is the Dodgers song, and Look Out for the Cheaters is the Astros song. It is perfect.
I cannot every wait time, to rock my A's jersey.
Every time they come up, you know, when they go back, they come up to bat, they should automatically start playing this song.
Oh, they will.
Yeah.
I don't know if it'll be that, but it'll be something along those lines. And they should.
Yeah.
So Rob Manfred did not vacate. Rob Manfred did not punish any of the players involved in this. And it does not appear, at least at this point, that he's going to change his mind. Maybe if the pressure continues to build, he has to readdress. But right now, we're all the commissioner, and we get to punish the Astros. You can't vacate. You can't do any of those things. You can't suspend any of these guys. You have to operate under the current setup. But you get to devise a punishment specific for the Astros for the upcoming season. What do you do, Key?
Morning. Good morning. I know it's been a tough week for all of us here in Major League Baseball. It's been a long and thoughtful process about what's been going on. And we all know, that's the cameras, about what's going on. And what we've decided in the commissioner's office, the best thing to do in Major League Baseball in terms of, you know, I know all of you. I know all of you want to hear what's going on and what we've decided. What we've decided here at Major League Baseball as a commissioner, in my cabinet, in my group, in my chief of staff, we've been up for quite some time, and we're going over many, many formats. And one of them is here that we proposed to the cameras and fix the mic.
Uh-huh.
That in the Houston Astros 2017 thing, we're not going to have them vacate the championship.
What?
Gasp.
Can I see the new cards? Which new cards, bro?
For the 2020 season of
which ones
Houston,
you?
They will be free in Houston.
That's blasphemy.
Perfect. All the games.
Which ones you trying to check out? I need to sell these real quick. Hold up.
They will be free. The box seats in Houston, Minute Maid Field, will have plenty of orange juice and every other beverage that they have. And you can get into a lottery. We've decided to purchase those boxes, and we have not come up with the number, but it will be shortly on what that amount will cost. We will donate those proceeds to the J.J. Watt Foundation, and J.J. Watt will distribute those funds wherever he may.
That's the punishment. I like that. It's an economic punishment.
Yes.
Give the people of Houston a chance to go see some games. I like that. Commissioner Granderson, you're at the mic.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, I'm going to be brief here. I know a lot of you want want me to vacate this title, and that's just not going to happen. We move past that. But in order for us to properly punish the Houston Astros in a way that I think they will feel it, we're moving the team to San Antonio.
Really?
They would now be known as the San Antonio Astros, where they'll be forced to eat off the Riverwalk every day.
Oh, no!
You will be now known as the San Antonio Astros.
What about the press?
Nope, no more Houston. No more at the Galleria. No Galleria. Now you have to shop at the Walgreens. That's over by the Alamo.
Okay.
Thank you.
Not bad. All right.
Hope you get fired.
Commissioner Rogers.
Mm-hmm.
Mine is simple. Mine is you reap what you sow. And for the upcoming season, I have decided that the Houston Astro pitchers will be required to alert the batter of the next pitch.
Oh, I like that.
That if you violate the rules, if you, for instance, say that a fastball is coming and throw an off-speed pitch, that batter will immediately be awarded first base. You got to play a season knowing every pitch that was coming. Now everyone else gets to play a season where they know what's coming against you.
Here comes a curveball.
Mr. Judge, you are the first batter. Mr. Trout, take the plate.
Right.
That you cheated like this, we're going to give them the very same advantage. Because here's the thing.
Mm-hmm.
You don't think that the Houston Astros pitchers would feel a certain way about saying, hey, Mike Trout, fastball. Hey, Aaron Judge, I'm going to throw you the curveball right here. Okay? Because this is what the Astros had advantage on the rest of the league. They knew what was coming.
Travis, it didn't impact the end of the game at all.
Uh-huh.
That's what they all said.
If it doesn't impact the game, then go ahead and tell me what's coming.
This is what they got. This is what you get. Every Astro pitcher would quit baseball. Justin Verlander, you're pitching Aaron Judge right now. You have to tell him what's coming. You like your chances? Not really. I got a chance, but my margin went from, I got a pretty good... Aaron Judge is a great hitter. Let's say he hits 300.
Mm-hmm.
I got a 70% chance of getting that guy out if he doesn't know what's going on. What is it now? That I have to be perfect with my location. And, oh, by the way, he can just spit on whatever it is he doesn't like until he gets two strikes. I know that it would never happen, but can you imagine what the Astro players would feel like if they knew that every single guy knew what was coming
and
what a ridiculous advantage?
It would be unfair.
That's the advantage they had.
It would be ticked off. Dusty Baker would be trying to explain, you know, why this is unfair.
Why is that not on the table? Give me one good reason that's not fair.
Well, because you might as well just take them away then for the year because they're going to lose the majority of the game.
That's what they did to everybody else.
I understand.
And they would lose a million games, and the ERA of the pitchers would skyrocket.
Two runs don't make a
difference. This is what happened to everybody else.
But then, economically, you would be punishing certain players that, you know, coming up on contracts, things of that nature.
Shouldn't have cheated.
But they probably didn't cheat, though. They probably just joined the team or anything like that. Like a Dusty Baker, for instance.
Nobody's going to make Dusty Baker responsible for it. He didn't do it.
Poor Dusty.
Dust's not going
to... Yeah, but you want Dusty's record to be...
Tarnished.
Tarnished?
He didn't have to take the job.
Oh, God. Well,
eye for an eye.
You going to move Dusty to San Antonio?
I'm going
to
move. Three games in San Antonio, and you get to know what pitch is coming.
And we donate all the proceeds to J.J. Watt.
Yeah, J.J. Watt gets a whole bunch of money along the way. Take it or shake it. Coming up next on The Morning Show, 710 ESPN.
Don't miss the new 710 ESPN weekday lineup in your city on your station talking about your team. Your team. The Morning Show with Keyshawn, LZ, and Travis, 6 to 10. We are back live and local from 10 to noon with the Sedano Show. Will Kane helps you follow your North Star until 3. Mason and Ireland in your afternoon. And Alan Sliwa from 6:30 to 9 p.m. 710 ESPN. We are your sports station.
Guys, stop sacrificing taste for performance when it comes to sports nutrition. The BodyTech brand has flavors as mighty as you are, like cereal-inspired protein and more, all powered by leveled-up taste technology and only at the Vitamin Shoppe. Discover a huge selection of trusted supplements independently tested to ensure quality and potency, including pre-workouts, aminos, BC2As, and protein, all backed by quality promise and engineered to deliver results to help you activate your best body, no matter what level that you're at. from sucks that make your workout stronger to tools that help you recover and come back even better. This is Rocket Fuel for your goals. Ready to find out what your body's made of? Let's do this. The Body Tech brand. No limits. Find Body Tech Sports Nutrition at the Vitamin Shop store near you or online at vitaminshop.com.
Today I want to thank the mayor of this great city, Mayor Bloomberg, for his extraordinary leadership. At a time when Washington is divided in old ideological battles, he shows us what can be achieved when we bring people together to seek pragmatic solutions. Not only has he been a remarkable leader for New York, he's established himself as a major voice in our national debate on issues like renewing our economy, educating our children, and seeking energy independence.
President Obama and Mike Bloomberg have worked together on gun safety, on education to help every child in every community get ahead, and on ways to improve youth employment through skill training and mentoring. They share a commitment to making the American dream work for everyone.
So, Mr. Mayor, I share your determination to bring this country together to finally make progress for the American people.
I'm Mike Bloomberg, candidate for president, and I approve this message.
Paid for by Mike Bloomberg 2020.
Progressive presents Get Pumped. Inspiration to help you do insurance stuff.
Hey, get your head in the game. This ain't no exhibition match. This is for real. You've got a house to insure, and there are no excuses because Progressive's Home Quote Explorer makes it easier than ever to get the coverage you need. Here's some music to get you pumped. You don't feel that confidence. Did I say stop saving money? No!
Progressive Casualty Insurance Company affiliates and other insurers.
Isaac, you missed the winning dunk and cost your team the championship. What are your thoughts?
Not good.
Well, I switched to Boost Mobile and got a super fast network and 4 free Samsung Galaxy A20 phones, so even when we lose, I still win.
It was an easy, fast break, and no one was near you.
You know what's fast? Boost Mobile's super fast network.
They're calling your shot the greatest miss in history.
Boost Mobile's prices are never a miss. I even get 4 lines for $25 per line per month.
Oh, look at that. The fans are burning your jersey.
Yep, the fans get it. My Boost Mobile network is en fuego.
Switch to Boost Mobile and get 4 lines for $25 per line per month with unlimited data and 4 free Samsung Galaxy A20 phones, all on our super reliable, super fast network. Step up with Boost Mobile. New customers only. Limited time offer while supplies last. Requires 1 port and eligible carrier and activation. 1 free device per line. Customers who use more than 35 gigabytes of data during a billing cycle will be deprioritized during times of network congestion. Offers and coverage not available everywhere. See BoostMobile.com or retailer for full details.
This segment is driven by Culver City Mazda. Find a more inspired drive this month with vehicles built for the LA driver at Culver City Mazda. With 0.9% financing for up to 72 months and up to $3,000 customer cash on select vehicles. Make Culver City Mazda the only place to get your Mazda.
It's time for Keyshawn's Take It. Or Shake It.
All right, Key, let's start with the NFL. The Rams are not going to send either of their coordinators, and Sean McVay is only going to Indianapolis for one day for the combine. The Rams don't need to have their coordinators and their head coach there for the full combine. Take it or shake it.
Shake it. I would love to see. I mean, at the end of the day, they certainly, Sean McVay certainly needs to be there to be able to see the prospects in person. I understand you rely on the scouts. I understand that that's what they're paid to do. Assistant coaches are paid to evaluate, but you are paid to evaluate up close and personal with your own eyeballs to help make that decision. I get it, the general manager's doing it, but I think that the head coach should be there. Now, I don't know how in-depth the coordinators are in terms of calling plays or doing whatever they're going to do with the Rams, but I think that the staff should be there and paying attention because it's important to see, feel, touch.
To eyeball
guys, even though it's a t-shirt Olympics, walking around. I mean, it's shorts. That's what it is, but I still want to know, I mean, how much weed you smoke? I mean, I understand that I can get you in on the 30-30 visits, where each team gets 30 guys that can come in to facility before the draft, and you can do all of that there, but there may be a guy like an LZ Granderson that you didn't really notice or see. All of a sudden, you get an opportunity to see him, because if you're sitting in your room and they're showing it on television, they skip guys. But you don't see everybody.
Mm-hmm.
They only show the big prospects working out. They don't show a little guy like a Raj in the corner
that you get a chance to see if you're there. But I wonder if they're identifying a guy. I mean, put it this way. If all of a sudden I'm at the combine, I just go, hey, who's that? Then I'm a bad scout. I should know that guy before we get to the combine.
Sometimes you do, but you don't know him because you didn't see him and you didn't get a chance to speak to him one-on-one. When I get you in that environment,
oh, my God. Oh, shit.
The room is about this size, little box. And there's about four or five dudes that's in the room. General manager, head coach,
goodness.
And there's always, I'm going to speed it up. There's always, I know you're going to laugh at this, there's some little old white dude in the corner. And he ain't really saying nothing. He's just sitting back there. He ain't saying nothing. He's just watching you talk to the coaches. And he's just sitting there acting like he ain't paying no attention. He's the psych of the team.
Yeah, I was going to say.
He ain't even said, and he just, you leave, he go over there, he's lying.
Hey, let me ask you a question.
All right.
Are they really going to ask me how sweet I smoked?
Somebody should ask Greg Robinson. We'll get to that coming up a little bit later on.
That's my dog.
Josh Reddick of the Astros said...
Rest your teeth, watch your face. We're about to go, boo-boo.
...this season by going out there and winning. If the Astros perform at a high level and win, this will mean far less, take it or shake it. Somebody else was doing better than him, and he wanted to compete, and it got too competitive, and all of a sudden, his head exploded, basically. Now, just because one person did it doesn't mean... you got to go out there and do what you was already
doing. You know what, Key? I would love to be with you on that one, but I'm not. If the Astros go out there and win that division and go into the playoffs and make some noise, you guys are a fraud.
But that's true.
Go away, they're pretty good anyway.
They are pretty good anyway. They were pretty good anyway. They didn't cheat on everybody. Not every night they were cheating.
Here's the problem.
You think they cheated 182 games?
I think that they cheated.
See, you still don't know that you're guilty. You know what I'm saying? Like, you say stuff like that when people are hating on you for no reason. You don't say that when you're guilty.
Let's go.
You're guilty. It's not about shutting everybody up. You earned this work, dog.
All right, back to the NFL. The Saints should split snaps between Drew Brees and Taysom Hill to keep Brees fresh for the postseason.
Shake it.
Hey, by the way, it's popping up in more and more places. You know why they like Taysom Hill? Because they can put him in. They can put Drew Brees on the side. He can stay fresh.
People just talking. He's going to get his little 10 snaps of fake offense throughout the season. That's not going to happen.
He was their best player in the postseason.
In that one game.
Yeah, he did some stuff.
Yeah.
Because they allow him to play trick football. That's all. It's video game Madden football.
So instead of doing two plays a game with him, could you not do six?
No, you could do 10 plays.
But Keith, think about it this way. There's not another team in the league that takes their quarterback, much less Drew Brees off the field for 10 snaps a game.
Because that offense that Sean likes that. I mean, that's what he likes to do. The New England Patriots don't have a Taysom Hill on their team to be able to give him some reps at that type of stuff.
That's an interesting point. If they did, let's say that Taysom Hill you snap your fingers, he's in New England. Is Bill Belichick taking Tom Brady off the field for 10 snaps a game?
He probably would do it.
Really?
To get that guy on the field, because that look, that defense is an element of surprise. It's, okay, who is he going to throw? Is he going to run? Okay, that's what it is. I've seen it many times. This isn't the first time that teams have had a quarterback like this and been taking him off the field. It's not. Think about it. It's just not. We did it when we had Ray Lucas and Vinny Testaverde.
Vinny Testaverde was not Drew Brees.
He still was a pocket passer. And Ray Lucas was a runaround, so it was just a change of pace.
Why do you need a brother like that? Man, he'll run around.
He wasn't running around.
All right, good. Stay with the NFL. Let's stay with the quarterbacks. Let me be very specific. Ryan Tannehill gives the Tennessee Titans a better chance to win next season than Tom Brady would. Take it or shake it.
Oh, pause is long.
No. Take it.
All right.
Take it.
You like Tannehill more than Brady in that
situation? Yeah, because you get Tom Brady there. Now all of a sudden, he's got to get accustomed to the offensive play call. He's got to get accustomed to the receivers. And when you, like all coaches, when you got a guy like that, you're gonna try to lean on him, Now you're going to force Brady to have to do everything. You're not going to treat Brady like Tannehill. You're not going to treat Brady like Garoppolo. Because you got Tom Brady, you automatically going to assume, okay, he's going to throw it all over the lot. Now you're changing your game plan because you forget about the big guy behind him. That happens.
It's fascinating because to go to a new place, you got to learn a new system, you got to all of that stuff. And what the Titans had worked really well.
It did.
It worked really well.
And I don't know, from my perspective, Key, it seems that if you know Tom Brady's back there, the defense is just going to respect certain throws more than if it's Tannehill.
That may be true, but what happens in an offensive coordinator's mindset and philosophy is, you know, when they get a whole bunch of toys
to play with,
they get to play, ooh, I got Tom Brady now, we can throw 50 times.
All right, very quickly, let's go to an NBA one very quickly. Steph Curry is expected to come back next month.
Why?
In March. Steph Curry should stay on ice. Take it or shake it.
Take it!
Hey, yo, thanks for that light.
Take it. Only get the lottery pick and keep it moving.
The post more pictures, though, on vacation.
With that in mind, Frank Vogel, the head coach of the Lakers, scheduled to join us next on the morning show on 710 ESPN.
Imagine watching LeBron, AD, and your Lakers live at Staples and inside a suite. Listen Monday morning at 7:40 for Keyshawn to give you the Lakers keyword. Write it down. Then listen in the 8 and 9 a.m. hour to the morning show. When Key tells you to call, be caller 7 with the right keyword and you're into the sweet life.
It's Keyshawn. Time for the Lakers keyword.
From the home of the Lakers, 710 ESPN.
Hey, you know, Travis, it's never too late to show your sweetheart to love him.
That's right. Never too late during the month of love. Show your boo a good time at the best resort in Funner, California. That's right. Harrah's Resort SoCal is offering an amazing opportunity to up your romance game. Listen to the morning show next Wednesday and listen to call in to win a free room and $150 in resort credit. That's right, a free room and $150 in resort credit. Or go to visitfunner.com right now and you get 30% off your room rates with promo code ESPNLA. Promo code ESPNLA. Now subject to availability and reserve now and your sweetheart will thank you. Harrah's Resort SoCal is the perfect escape for dreaming up your favorite kind of fun. Trust me, they've got award-winning pools, comedy, and concerts to excite, plus relaxing spa treatments and a world-class gaming floor. Book now and your girl will thank you.
This is your last chance to book an Anaheim Ducks suite for your next private or corporate outing. Enjoy all-inclusive food and beverage, reserved parking, private entrances, and more. For more information, visit AnaheimDucks.com/last chance.
Hit by an Uber or Lyft? They carry big insurance. Let's get what you deserve.
That player is the way to go. Call 800-920-0810.
Donald Stevenson Esquire. Results may vary. No guarantee. Not a time for Uber or Lyft and does not imply any affiliation or
rights
by them.
Making Moves is brought to you by LinkedIn.
On winning teams, every player brings their unique strength that has an impact on the results. For Kevin McHale, that meant coming off the bench for the Boston Celtics. Of his almost 1,000 career games, he only started 400 of them. Yet McHale helped lead the Celtics to 3 NBA championships, played in 7 All-Star games, and was inducted into the Hall of Fame.
Build your winning team today. Go to linkedin.com/sports.
You wouldn't draft a point guard to play center, right?
We just waiting for the, what's the name, man? We just waiting. Hopefully by the time I get back, they have dropped this. Nothing yet. Let me refresh my shit. Need that update. Ready, Zoe? You got your back? Ah. Shit. Back up, back up. This the man right here. Oh, we gotta get him another shoe. Oh, yeah, gotta get him another shoe. But yeah. This car right here is crazy. Crazy. It's prime time. It's prime, not spotlight. It's up. It is? Hold on, player. Hold on, player. Oh, not yet. For more details and to shop our inventory, visit RustnackBMW.com. Oh, it's a Prime series, huh? 1.9%. Well, all right. Is $21.47 per month per thousand. Financed over 48 months on select 2016, 2018 CPO models. On approved credit through BMW. I'll start to be up in a second. All advertised prices. So I guess we opening up a pack. 10% average down payment required. We opening up a box. That's what's about to happen. That's what's about to happen. Westbrook and Klay Thompson. Thanks for that info. We gonna Well, whatever they what's the name? I'll either open up a box or Well, we gonna At first glance, I think there's a lot more upside than there. Yeah, everybody was talking about it was gonna be a spotlight challenge last night. Always go to the money when you start talking about expanding anything, because that's what it boils down to. You know, close to $5 billion. You saying yeah, money in the prime. So when you look at that, but it is a prime. Westbrook and Klay Thompson. Shit, I don't know if I want. We'll see what else come in that pack. I might get it. So it should be a new prime pack probably in a second. Alright. Oh. Let's see what's popping. I'll be right back.
Make sure that you stick around for that. Coach Frank,
do we give Sean McVay the credit for killing the preseason? Did it get, because a lot of teams followed suit when he didn't play anybody. Other teams started to do it. Did the league say, hey, look, nobody's going back the other way. We're not going to see the players in these games. Let's start to eliminate these and find other ways to get real players on
the field. That conversation's been going on since I played, man, about eliminating preseason games.
But you played in the preseason.
But it's been going on for a while.
I understand
about
that.
Adding extra games and eliminating the preseason.
I get that, and you're right.
Those are conversations, though.
Exactly.
Sean McVay had action.
Bingo. Sean McVay is the one that said none of my guys are playing in this.
There's teams prior to Sean McVay that didn't play guys in the preseason. Not everybody.
To the extent of McVay?
Not to the extent of McVay. But there's been teams where you said to guys, well, you're not going to play, man. You just get dressed. It's happened. He's not the innovator. I'm sorry, I'm not going to give him the full credit for that. He certainly may have opened up more eyes toward a successful season in doing that. But then the flip side of it is you look at what he did last year, and he did the same thing, and they didn't have a great year.
I understand, and I get that not everybody played in every preseason game, that if there was any something going on, you would sit a guy down. But Sean McVay was the first guy, and tell me if I'm wrong, I don't think I am, to universally say, to kind of philosophically say, no matter what, Jared Goff's not stepping on that field.
I understand. I get that. But the San Francisco 49ers played a lot of their guys and then went to the Super Bowl. So, you understand what
I'm
saying?
There we go.
It's like,
49ers played some of the guys, man, they held the Super Bowl.
So why did it happen now? And just so we're clear.
There it is. What up, Blend? Probably, if in fact it was my day yesterday. I turned 19. Hey, happy birthday, bro. We're going to open up a box. As soon as I get back, we're going to open up a box. Soon as I get back, we're gonna open up a box.
Okay. But why did we finally get to the point? Because you said keep going back to when you were playing and before you.
Because if you have enough conversations about
it, damn, I should do it now.
Time, it's eventually gonna come to head, right? I mean, it's eventually gonna surface and people gonna say, yeah, that make a lot of sense. That's it's not. You can't talk about it today and it happen tomorrow. You gotta talk about it today and it'll happen.
Years?
Man, they take forever to do something. How many times we going back and forth with replay? Back now they're revisiting they're gonna revisit the penalties in terms of pass interference again.
Yeah.
They're just going to go back and forth. Remember, many years ago, their instant replay system was in, and then they got taken out, and they came back with it. I mean, that's just...
They do go back and forth on some stuff, but this is the first time we've seen a change like this since they went from 14 to 16. This is the first time we've seen the playoff field expand from what would be 12 to 14 since going back to 19.
Trying to get that account still.
This is a real change.
Hey, we got the VC. As soon as I get back, we're going to pop them up, but I should pop them up now. Who you get? A Opal.
Well, let's find out if it works for everybody this year, and let's find out if the 17 games work and less preseason.
Damn, I want to open it now.
Let's do it like this. We all, I think, are excited.
What time is it? 8:02?
I think we're all excited about the new. What are the potential downfalls?
Fuck it.
What are the potential problems with adding a game?
Fuck it. Let's open it now. Fuck it.
Because
hold up.
As we look at it,
drum roll.
There doesn't seem to be a real
drum roll.
This could be a problem. There's some little things like it's harder for the number two seed to get there, but if that's the biggest downside, then there's not much downside.
I don't think there's any downside to it.
Drum roll. Wish me luck. Come on. This is not looking good. Absolutely trash. Ugh. We remember what happened last time. No, hold on. Let me see. Hold on. Remember what happened last time. Come on. What that mean? What is that? What is this? Pink diamond? Ah, another one. Should I pull? Nah, it wasn't no PD. Fuck it. Let's see what happens. Come on. Fuck! All good. I ain't tripping. We Gucci. We got a bunch of bullshit that I'll take care of when I get back.
Alright. Well, be right back.
What's up, DJ? What up, Trusty? I just hit 900 subs last night, 1K. On the way. That's what's up. That's what's up. Shout out to my boy, Trusty.
Sometimes he's not on the floor in the fourth quarter simply because
other guys in the team are playing well. We've had, we've had a great season in terms of our role players, having mindset that different guys are going to step up each night. You know, we have a game last week, and Alex Caruso comes in, on what was supposed to be a small minute stint, and he plays out of his mind, So he gets Caruso's minutes in that role, and LeBron slides to the four. Avery Bradley's had stretches where he's played out of his mind. Rajon Rondo has played out of his mind. Danny Green has played out of his mind. Contavious Caldwell-Pope. We've had situations where our two centers were playing extremely well, so we keep AD at the four. So it's really just a matter of we're gonna go with guys that are sort of on that night. Kuz is right in that mix. He's got plenty of nights where he's the guy that's, we just ride him out. So he's been wonderful in terms of being a selfless player with regard to his role this year. Everybody knows what he can do as a starter and in a big minutes role, but if other guys are going a little bit higher than he is, then those guys are going to get those minutes. And that's been one of the beautiful things about our team this year is we've had different guys step up each night.
I want you to go back to Sunday. Your guy AD is at the free throw line. The game is in his hands. He shoots the first free throw. Your thoughts?
Same thing LeBron was saying. It's over. As soon as he got fouled, I said, this game's over. I almost went to the locker room. Like Paul Pierce, when he made that shot in the playoffs a couple years ago and just called game. As soon as he got fouled, I said, this game's over.
But then he bricked it.
I was a little surprised he missed the first one, but there's no way he was missing both of them. There's no way. So, I was very confident, and that was a fun experience. That was a great game.
Sorry, Coach, I had to ask you those questions like a germ spread. I got a can of Lysol here, and now there's a spread all over my body. Perfect.
You're not a player anymore, Keith. You're a media member.
No, I'm not. Thank you. I have no credentials that says media.
Yes, you do. I've seen them. He's lying to you, Coach, right now. He's absolutely telling you a lie. Laker head coach
Frank
Vogel.
You'll always be a player, right, Keith?
Exactly. Thanks, Coach. Appreciate your time.
Thanks, Coach.
All right, take care, guys.
All right.
Well, at least he knows my voice.
He's telling lies to the head coach of the Lakers. How dare you? All right. Your reaction to what you just heard from Frank Vogel, 877-710-3776, 877-710-ESPN. There is a whole bunch in there. We'll react to it as well, especially I like the part about being innovative and being creative moving forward, because that means something to me, at least, very specific. That's coming up next on The Morning Show on 710 ESPN.
Your city, your station, your two teams on 710 ESPN.
You're listening to 710 ESPN. More sports talk coming your way thanks to Mercury Insurance. California drivers save an average of $769 with Mercury Insurance. That's a lot of dough. Get a free quote today at mercuryinsurance.com to see how much you can save.
Hey guys, Mike Golic here. Athletes are still athletes when they're off the field. That's why they still need to make good choices, like staying hydrated with Bolt 24. With antioxidant vitamins A and C, electrolyte from watermelon and sea salt, and no artificial sweeteners or flavors. Bolt 24 is all-day hydration for all-day athletes. It's available in delicious flavors like watermelon, strawberry, tropical mango, and mixed berry, and can be found in the sports drink aisle at most major retailers. Bolt 24, all-day hydration.
The all-new Land Rover Newport Beach has a new owner, new showroom, new attitude. See our website or visit us with all your lease-end questions. Come check out the all-new Jaguar Land Rover Newport Beach at Jamboree by the Sea or check their vast inventory online at LandRoverNewportBeach.com at the only adventure sales event.
Owning Corporation, Equal Housing Lender, licensed by the Department of Business Oversight under the California Residential Mortgage Lending Act, NMLS 1797976. Call 833-852-6464 for terms and conditions.
Wow, the future always has surprises, good and bad. Who would have predicted that in the first part of 2020, mortgage rates have fallen to about all-time lows, yet world events have made it happen. So, if your 30-year fixed-rate mortgage is higher than 3.375%, you should call Oding at 855-5-ONING for a no-closing cost, as in no title, escrow, appraisal, lender, fees, etc. 30-year mortgage at 3.375 APR now, as in today. Every day you wait, you're burning cash, and, as we all know, the world turns in unexpected ways. Call Oding at 855-5-ONING or go to Oding.com for a 30-year fixed no-closing cost refi at 3.375% rate at APR. That's 855-5-OWNING for a 30-year fixed no closing cost rate and APR of 3.375% from owning.com.
I'm Candace Parker of your LA Sparks. To compete at the highest level, I recognize my values and what motivates me. I love the sport, the competition, and bringing home wins to my city. What motivates you? Do you value helping people, being a change leader in your community, and making our city a safer place? If so, LAPD is hiring people just like you. As a police officer for the LAPD, you have the power to not only make a difference in your life, but also in the community. Be the change you want to see. Go to joinlapd.com to learn more and apply online today.
You're in charge of hiring, and Indeed has solutions, like online skills tests, which let a candidate show that they're the right hire. And we'll give you this barbershop quartet who'll sing the name of the perfect hire.
Vince Lundy.
Vince Lundy.
Vince Lundy.
Okay, there's no quartet. But skills tests, that's a for sure.
See why independent research by Silk Road shows Indeed delivers three times more hires than any other job site. Visit Indeed.com/promo today and get a free sponsored job upgrade on your first posting. Terms, conditions, and exclusions apply.
Swing into Roger Don and check out Callaway's new Maverick line of drivers, fairwaywoods, irons, and hybrids. The new Maverick line has been made with artificial intelligence to optimize distance with industry-leading ball speeds. The Maverick, Maverick Max, and Maverick Sub-Zero driver faces have been uniquely engineered to improve clubhead speed and forgiveness. The Maverick irons have been made to ensure optimal launch conditions with unprecedented feel. Get custom fit today and receive a 50% trade-in bonus towards the new Maverick family. Roger Dunn Golf, home of the 90-day satisfaction guarantee.
You hear that? That's the sound of a good time outside. And that is the sound of it getting even better. Give your sunny days a refreshing kick with Twisted Tea Hard Iced Tea. Whether you're grilling out back, relaxing by the water, or just unwinding with your crew, Twisted Tea is everything you love about classic iced tea, because it's made with real brewed tea, but with a kick. Twisted Tea Hard Iced Tea. Unwind with a twist. Drink responsibly.
Score big savings on the Chevy car, truck, or SUV of your dreams at George Chevrolet. Your home for everyday low prices and award-winning customer service. Whether you're looking for a great deal on a new Chevy, quality used vehicle, service, or parts, George Chevrolet has got you covered. Centrally located off the 91 Freeway Lakewood exit in the city of Bellflower. And online at georgechevy.com. That's georgechevy.com. Since 1961, George Chevrolet. Chevrolet, find new roads.
Your guys.
But in terms of, as you go down that checklist of these different players, LZ.
Oh, George.
You, slow down, man.
I'm just give me the list.
Let's do it.
Because it's long.
He, you know,
the problem is a long list.
The problem is you're a damn journalist.
I wrote it.
And
you're sitting
here. Ernie on the Sprint People's Hotline.
Ernie.
Still pretty good luck. Ernie, you're on the morning show. What's up?
Morning, fellas. Morning.
Your teams. Your station. 710 ESPN.
All right, so Frank Vogel joined us last segment talking about a whole bunch of different things with the Lakers
sir.
Getting ready for the final 29 games of the season. It starts with the Memphis Grizzlies.
Yes.
John Morant, the national front runner for Rookie of the Year.
You keep laughing, dog.
I'm not laughing.
Like, he don't got highlights.
Yeah, he does.
Yeah, he's called.
Hey,
he's got serious highlights.
Hey,
but it ain't going to happen.
Let me just, you be honest, though. I know how you feel.
Yeah.
But be honest when I ask you this question. Who do you see more of on television?
Oh, Zion.
By a mile, right?
Yeah.
By a mile.
Yeah.
Well, because
that's gonna matter.
One, he's the number one pick in the entire draft.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
He was the Naismith, or whatever it's called, player of the year in college basketball. He blew out his shoe.
Yeah.
He has the biggest shoe contract going as a rookie. I mean, and he was traded for, I mean, and he's replacing essentially AD in New Orleans. So you're and there on ESPN. That's what you're going to get.
It's exactly what you're going to get. We'll get to that coming up in just a little bit. Frank Vogel sounded good. It sounded like he's ready for the second half. And I liked what he said about the question that I asked him about, because there really are two different philosophies as a coach. This is what we do, and we're going to make sure that we do it as best as we can. That's the Milwaukee Bucks philosophy, that this is what we do. Get ready to deal with us. And then there's the, hey, we're going to mix and match. And he said we got to find a way to do both. This was not, this is how we're going to roll. These are my five guys. So when he was talking about being innovative, being creative, I think mixing and matching lineups, that's what we're going to see in these final 29
games. Well, remember I said earlier that it's by committee. It's going to be, you know, it's going to be by committee. It's the mix and the match. That's what it is. The mix and the match is not going to be with AD and LeBron.
and mix and match is going to be with everybody else.
But the mix and the match could be all of a sudden you stumble into a mix that you're like, bing, that's it right there. That's the one that works best. That it might not work in every situation. You're obviously going to be a little bit flexible, but all of a sudden, maybe you do find a line of combination like Vogel was talking about that says, ooh, there it is right there. Those five guys together give us the best options across the board. Size, speed, athleticism, shooting, defensively, that's the match.
Yeah, but this all depends upon who they're facing and how the other team is playing and how they're playing. I mean, when you look at Avery Bradley and KCP, for instance, they do slightly different things, but they're operating in terms of rotation interchangeably. So if Avery Bradley is cooking, he's going to eat. And if he's not cooking and KCP is, he's going to eat. So those are the tweaks we've been seeing throughout the course. I talked about it before, last game of the season before the All-Star break. You know, it's like he looked like going, JaVale McGee's having problems with Jokic's size. I'm going to put Dwight on. And Dwight's going to start the second half, and that's just the adjustments that you make when you're a smart head coach. It's not the 80s anymore, you know, where this is your starting lineup, this is who's closes. Now, because of the skill sets have changed, because of the schemes have changed so much, you can't have this flexibility.
I don't disagree with that, but I do think there's something to be said for everybody knowing exactly what they're going to be asked to do every single night is valuable. I'm not saying that you'd be rigid.
Be ready.
Yeah, you can't be rigid in how you do it, but I do think that everybody needs to know their role before we even start the games. Let's try the Valley on the Sprint People's Hotline. And Kevin, you're on the morning show. What's up?
Hey, guys. Good morning. Love the show. It's an honor to talk to you guys this morning. Yeah, listening to that Frank Vogel interview, man, that guy sounds confident. Sounds comfortable. Yeah, I was real, you know, starstruck by his tone. Look, I think the Lakers got enough now. You know, they're 5 games up right now, up with the Clippers, 4 games up on Denver right now. Everybody talks about adding this or adding that. I think if this team does it by committee, I think the Lakers will take their championship this year, and I think they're very confident in that. But one thing that they keep going back to, they keep going back and talking about chemistry, the locker room. Don't want it to disturb that. This is a special unit. This is a special group, and I think that group is going to end up winning the championship this year if they stay healthy and play as the team that they've been playing all year.
No, I have a lot of confidence in their ability to win a championship. Absolutely. My only concern is that say you find yourself in a playoff series and from some quirky, you know, fault of no one else's, LeBron James picks up 2 fouls in the first quarter and has to sit a little bit. Now you kind of need the offense to keep trucking, but we already have empirical data that tells us that when LeBron sits down, the offense slows down a great deal. So my only issue is, can we kick a tire here or there just to find one more guy who, in the event that Rondo doesn't have it going, can come in and maybe keep the thing going if LeBron James picks up 2 fouls in the first quarter?
Well, that's where the mix and the match comes in at. That's where trying to understand what players are on the floor with who at some point in time. Before you get to the playoffs, you'll have an understanding as a coaching staff. That's where it comes in.
Let's try Santa Clarita. Next stop on the Sprint People's Hotline. And
I'm back.
Martin, you're on the morning show. What's up?
And can you please show me how much Klay Thompson is going for? How much does Buddy Hield go for? Can you show me, please?
I'm particularly glad that they did not trade.
Yeah, I'll show you, bro. I just got back. Let me see what's up. Let me see what's up. Hold up.
Second unit.
least for the most part, until they lose another one to Milwaukee or Toronto or whoever it is. But they can take care of that. I want to go back.
Oh my god. That fucking card art looks fucking terrible.
What people see, and they don't see him playing at a level on the court.
This card art looks terrible.
This happens typically, as you know, with professional athletes. If you don't put out, they say you're concentrating on more off the court things than you are your game, then you should be concentrating on your game. But I want to be specific off the court. I understand that that's what they're going to say. I understand that it's going to look bad. I understand that it's an easy, he's got yellow hair, therefore he's not prepared to play basketball. I understand that it's an easy
weird, though, right?
Jump to make. But my point, that third guy in a LeBron-led team always has a hard time finding his way.
Yeah.
He's not unique in that regard.
Nope.
His number.
This card art is terrible.
Been the other 2 years. They're a little bit different.
Oh my god! Hell no.
So his numbers are going to come down just because Anthony Davis.
Hell no.
The numbers are out of shape. He's not a problem on the team.
No,
there's
look at
no
this shit.
You can say this is leading to.
Do y'all see this shit?
Other than this is what happens when you're the third guy on the team. But it's
this fucking the card art on the cards look terrible, bro.
It's the struggles that make you say, ugh.
Oh my god. Damn, that shit look terrible. That shit look bad.
Those sort of things. Because the numbers are the numbers.
That shit look real bad, B. Look at this shit. Why it look like that? Maybe just because it hasn't updated yet?
To take on the Lakers tomorrow night. Is he going to win the MVP? Excuse me, the rookie of the year. Not MVP. Or is Zion going to run him down? Not should he, will he? That's coming up next on the morning show, 710 ESPN.
It's the Sedano Show. Now weekdays from 10 to noon after the morning show. Like LeBron,
he's up already.
A ridiculous breakfast every morning. And he loves sweets. And eats dessert with every single
person.
I mean, I do too, but I don't look like LeBron. I mean, I was just
yeah, man, I gotta put everything, all this shit in the damn, what's the name? They could have dropped that Kobe spotlight. Yeah, they should have, man. Like, it's a waste of time, bro. These fucking cars is trash. Cars is trash, bro.
His world champ Deontay Wilder faces lineal champ Tyson Fury live from Las Vegas. Two undefeated heavy hitters squaring off for the second time in the most anticipated rematch in recent heavyweight history. The fight is this Saturday, February 22nd. The fight is at 6 o'clock and it is live on pay-per-view.
This month we celebrate National Battery Day, so remember to get your vehicle's battery tested.
This time, give me some MT.
If it needs to be replaced, we have batteries starting at just $79.99. And the best part, installation is free. Plus, Speed Perks members get 500 bonus Speed Perks points when you purchase a gold or platinum battery until February 26th. Think ahead. Think advance at Advance Auto Parts and participating CarPlus locations. Free installation with purchase, most vehicles, most locations.
Come show love for your favorite sports team at Spring Garden Grove, Saturday, February 22nd from 12 to 2 p.m. Wear your team gear for a chance to win a trip for two to the ultimate.
Almost done with my Jeremy Lin. Oh, yeah, I know. I was looking at that shit. You're a beast with that. I can't. Ooh, shit. But, I mean, I guess. Yeah. Might as well, shit. Oh my god, I didn't know. Now they send me this many players. All the silvers, too. Ooh, I'll take them. A lot of silvers.
MVP?
Why do I keep saying that?
Because you want him to win the MVP.
The rookie of the year.
I don't think that there's any question that he should, right? Because he's going to have played an entire season. He's going to have played really well during an entire season. He's going to have taken a Memphis team that has really no business being the first season.
Should have been trash.
Right, and they're going to, they've got a real shot to make the playoffs. So that's all his resume. The Zion Williamson piece of it, keep everything that you just said, that his, one, it's just his physique, the way that he's built is unique. The blowout of the shoe, the fact that he went to Duke, all of these things that we pay attention to. And by the way, ESPN and TNT and everybody that is selling the NBA is fully in the Zion Williamson business.
There's no difference in there's no difference between him and a Baker Mayfield or him and Johnny Manziel when he came into the league. When you are the hype machine and you're selling, as long as you're producing, it's going to keep selling. The problem with some of those other guys is they hype fizzles out because their game fizzles. It never really takes off. His game is doing what it, we said it would do.
Yes.
And so he's going to get the necessary eyeballs, the support, but because he came so late, I think Ja.
That's right.
I want to call him Ja?
The same reason I keep trying to give him the MVP, I guess.
Morant.
We'll give Ja Morant the MVP then.
Morant is so far out, it's hard to close that ground, you know? It's just hard to make that up.
But you know, real talk though, even if Zion started at the same place, to me, Ja has inside track, and this is why.
What's a cheaper PD?
Right now,
for what? Like what position you trying to get? For what position?
That's fine. The Zion team was trash too. And
No. Drew Holiday is a former All-Star.
But they were not good
like that though. And he added something to them. He gave them some stack, crackle pop, some spark. If he start, how many games did we watch or did we see?
What position, K-Dubs?
The Pelicans?
Yeah. So he make up those games. He plays in those games. Those are more eyeballs and voters that see him. It's just, he comes in with the hype. And on top of that, when you come in with the hype, they want you to win it.
That's what they want you to win. That's a different question than the conversation we're having, which is it's a should, not a would.
The
should is Ja Morant should be Rookie of the Year.
Right now, yes.
Right now. But and if the Pelicans don't catch them in the postseason for a postseason race,
they're going to win.
He's still going to win it. Yeah. Our point, me and Travis's point is, he's
gaining ground. Cheap PD. Hold on. Hold on, I'll tell you right now. But I think a cheap PD. Oh, Blackman, I think he's like 20K. How much you got? How much you trying to spend? You say you got like 30K? Get a. Hold on, big fella.
Here's why LeBron James.
Hold on.
Right? Because LeBron James is LeBron James.
Exactly right. And Zion potentially could be LeBron James 20 years. I don't like saying this, but I'm going to say it anyway. was right again about Johnny Boy. I'll tell you which.
Where's Johnny Boy?
The Johnny Boy. Okay. That's coming up next on the Morning Show, 710 ESPN.
And you know what also is coming up? A chance to be down with us at our third annual LAFC kickoff party, and we're giving away passes every hour. That's right. Here's how you can win. Call 877-710-ESPN and call number 7, Keyshawn, who can tell me.
Number 7!
That's right. What Laker member we had on? We had a member of the Los Angeles Lakers on earlier. You answer that, you win a 4-pack of tickets to come check us out.
All right, we'll be broadcasting live on Friday, February 28th. That's 1 week from tomorrow at the Bank of California Stadium. Everybody in attendance is going to have a chance to win home opener tickets, autograph merch, and more. And that's all thanks to Valvoline Instant Oil Change. Visit SoCalOilChange.com for locations and for coupons off of your next oil change at the Valvoline Instant Oil Change.
Mason in Ireland, the show where it's all happening.
Okay, I've complained before. I'm going to complain again.
About
can
what?
We get rid of the word fellas? I can't stand the word what? Fellas. I feel like it's like 1973.
You're
fellas.
Made up.
No, it's not. No fellas. Nobody says fellas. No, who says? When was the last time you used the word fellas? Hey,
yesterday.
Fellas.
Literally.
No, you did not.
Mason and Ireland, coming up this afternoon, 3.
710 ESPN.
Hello, L.A. This is Ken Chris, general manager of Rustneck BMW at the Thousand Oaks Auto. Whether you're trying to hit a slider, connect with your receiver on a post route, or throw up an alley-oop for a monster dunk, timing is everything. The same goes for buying a BMW. Right now at Rustneck BMW, we're hosting our certified pre-owned BMW event with APRs as low as 1.49% for terms up to 48 months across a select line of BMWs. Plus, with the holiday season over, we now have our best selection of certified BMWs, and this event will be gone soon, so timing is everything. For more details and to shop our inventory, visit RustneckBMW.com. Rustneck, your road awaits.
1.9% APR financing is $21.47 per month per thousand financed over 48 months on select 2016-2018 CPO models on approved credit through BMW Financial Services. All advertised prices exclude government fees and taxes. 10% average down payment required. Offer ends March 2nd, 2020.
Rewards bonus points month at O'Reilly Auto Parts. Earn double points on all sale items like wiper blades, motor oil, tools, and more. Are your wiper blades streaking, shattering, or skipping? Save $8 per pair on Bosch Icon wiper blades, plus earn double O rewards points. O'Reilly Auto Parts. Better parts, better prices every day.
Oh, 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 O'Reilly Auto Parts.
Have you still not refinanced your mortgage? Well, soon you might be kicking yourself in the head. Rates are at historic lows. So take advantage of our new fast-track loan with an unbelievable low rate of 3.375.
Oh, PD.
No closing costs.
That's right. Hold on.
Loan. That's right. No points, no fees. Hi, I'm Wesley Hogan with
Lennox. You can get Steve Nash for really cheap.
You can still probably save you money. All it takes
you can get Steve Nash for really cheap. You could get shit. You can get
one process can get it done in record time. So call today 844-425-3669. That's 844-425-3669. It's the biggest no brainer.
You can get
mankind. Call us at 844-425-3669.
Licensed by the Department of Business Oversight under the California Residential Mortgage Lending Act, NMLS number 3304.
Who else had a clean diamond? I was kind of cheap. Oh, you can get this Kawhi. Bro, you can get this Kawhi. You could probably get him for like 30K too. Look, he 35. 30, he probably, I know he's cheaper than that. 32K, look. 32K, you can get this Kawhi, bro. For kind of cheap. 30K, there go one right there, 30K. Yeah, I got you. And if you got like 40K, you can get the Kawhi and you, because you should be able to still get that Steve Nash for like 10K. These cars is cheap. They're not as good, but whatever. Yeah, I mean. Gotta do what you gotta do. Oh, get this Miles Bridges. Get that diamond Miles Bridges if you got enough. That motherfucker good.
Because look, maybe Tua is a bust. Maybe Justin Herbert is a bust. Joe Burrow.
I can do a lot of things with that fifth pick. If I can get my hands on a car for a 3 and a 4, a 4 and a 5, a throwaway, I can... Okay, we got a quarterback. He's really good. They've never had a... And I say this, Carr was on his way to becoming the MVP of the league, potentially. Miami has never picked up that guy before at quarterback. They haven't picked up that type of... Everything
has become available very often.
Exactly. And they've always picked up what no one else completely, like throwaway backup journeyman types.
So,
they picked up Dante Culpepper, man.
Derek Carr or Teddy Bridgewater?
For the Raiders.
For the Dolphins.
See,
Derek Carr or Cam Newton?
Derek Carr's going to be cheaper for me for the Dolphins than Teddy Bridgewater. Teddy Bridgewater is going to be a $30 million guy. Google it.
You better be right.
Google it.
Then if you're the Dolphins, you can get Teddy Bridgewater $30 million. You better get it right. He better be your guy.
Yes, but I'm going, if I'm the Raiders, I'm going to outbid the Dolphins for Teddy Bridgewater. Because I know Sean Payton is my best friend. We speak the same language. We have that conversation. Sean's going to be straight up with me what Bridgewater is, because he's had him for 3-4 years now, whatever it's been. So I know what that is, and I'm comfortable with him.
What the Raiders have that the team, for instance, like the Chargers do not have, is that they don't have to make a splash. The Raiders are going to be a smash hit no matter what they do in quarter. It could be Derek Carr. It could be me.
And even
watch the Raiders in Vegas.
Pickle face. Here's the one for you. Pickle face.
Pickle face.
Anything to get your attention. You know, you don't know somebody's name. And they turn and go,
you don't know my name?
No idea.
Pickle face, you got problems.
But you might not hear exactly what I said. But that's a good one for you, though. The Chargers. If Derek Carr is available, that might be a good one. And the reason it's a good one is because that's what they need.
Yeah, Matt Stafford's going to be in charge.
Yeah, well,
Matt Stafford.
We already moved on from Tom Brady.
Pickle face.
Michael Thompson is going to join us and tell us what he has in store for the final push of the Lakers. 29 games to go, believe it or not. That's coming up next on The Morning Show, 710 ESPN.
Yay!
710 ESPN. It's time for LAFC to kick off Season 3. And The Morning Show will have their annual exclusive kickoff party again, Friday, February 28th at Bank of California Stadium.
The crowd is going crazy at Bank of California!
Your way in. Keep listening to The Morning Show all week for your chance. Made possible by Valvoline Instant Oil Change. Visit SoCalOilChange.com for locations and coupons for your next oil change.
You're listening to 710 ESPN. More sports talk coming your way thanks to Mercury Insurance. California drivers save an average of $769 with Mercury Insurance. That's a lot of dough. Get a free quote today at MercuryInsurance.com to see how much you can save.
During the Ram President's Day event, we're leading the way with great deals. Now, while qualified or turning FCA plus
fucking,
leads on the 2020 Ram 1500 Bighorn Crew Cab 4x2 for $259 a month for 27 months with $4,269 new at signing.
The card art looks trash. That range extender though, Clay got that range extender. That shit gonna kill somebody. That shit gonna fuck you up.
Experience. So every hire you make is a win for your business. Go to LinkedIn.com.
LinkedIn.com/sports and get $50 off your first job post. That's LinkedIn.com/sports. LinkedIn.com/sports. Terms and conditions apply.
Hey there, homeowners. Are you experiencing pipe leaks? Do you have warm spots in your slab floor, or is your water bill unexpectedly high? These are signs of widespread pipe failure due to old, corroded, and shoddy pipes. Rerouting a pipe or other Band-Aid fixes are not the answer. Only a whole house repipe with brand new high-quality PEX or copper will permanently solve the problem. Repipe Specialists. No more leaks and great water pressure. They've been doing this for over 25 years. Repipe in just 1 to 2 days at half the cost of a plumber with a lifetime guarantee. Say goodbye to leaks once and for all and eliminate the risk of water damage to your home. Call us today for your free in-home estimate. We'll even take 20% off our already low price and receive 0% interest when you call today at 800-219-3803. 800-219-3803. That's 800-219-3803.
Saving is easy with Spectrum Mobile. Unlike other providers, you can actually mix and match our unlimited and buy the gig data plans so you can build the perfect family plan. Unlimited nationwide talk and text is always included. See for yourself with the Spectrum Mobile Savings Calculator. Go to spectrummobile.com/save and see how you could save up to 40% or more. Plus, you can change plans without penalty, and there are no added taxes, fees, or contracts. Visit spectrummobile.com/save. Restrictions apply. Check for details.
KSPN, Los Angeles. Your city, your teams, your station. 710 ESPN.
I promise that you'll never find another like me.
With the Capital One Saver Card, you earn 4% cash back on dining and entertainment. That's 4% cash back on milkshakes with extra whipped cream. And 4% to get extra loud at the show. Earn 4% on dining and 4% on entertainment. What's in your wallet?
Hey guys, it's Taylor. You can buy my new album, Lover, at taylorswift.com.
Terms apply. Capital One Bank, USANA.
And earlier this morning on The Morning Show,
Keyshawn, LC, and Travis, morning 6 to 10.
Frank Vogel joining us here on The Morning Show. Sorry, Coach, I had to ask you those questions like a germ spreader. I got a can of Lysol here. Now I'm going to spray it all over my body.
Oh, perfect. Well, you're not a player anymore, Keyshawn. You're a media member.
No, I'm not. Thank you. Oh, yes, you do. I've seen them. He's lying to you, Coach, right now. He's absolutely telling you a lie. Laker head coach,
you'll
Frank Boyle.
Be a player, right, Keyshawn?
Exactly.
Your morning show.
710 ESPN.
Greg Robinson has now 0-for-2 now, I guess.
He's
the number two player in the draft, and bonk, bonk.
Bonk, bonk, bonk.
Right? Les Snead has been really good at picking players.
Yes.
And especially in identifying those first-round guys. He's done a really good job.
Mm-hmm.
Greg Robinson is the exception. So,
it's so weird, though, when stuff like that happens. And this goes back to why I say you got to go to the combine.
Would he have told you that he had 175 pounds of weed in his car?
No, but but for me, I can judge and talk and smell and sniff and see if you really want to play football. It's not that Les Snead missed out on the talent side of it. What's his worth ethic? What type of dude was he? You know, what information did we really gather when he got? Was he the type of guy who's going to get drafted and then shut it down? Because clearly in college, Les Snead picked him as a number two pick. Les Snead wasn't the only person trying to get him. So obviously people saw him and loved his size and his athletic ability and the things he did in college.
He could face up to 20 years in prison. He was arrested yesterday for allegedly possessing 157 pounds of marijuana.
So you dropped him down about 20 pounds.
12, yeah. I gave him an extra 18.
18 pounds.
Yeah, he smoked that on the way to Canada.
157 pounds? I mean, this is not a joint. This is, you're a drug dealer. That's a lot. 157 pounds, you're a drug dealer.
But he drove all the way from L.A.
to El Paso, got pulled over. Didn't he realize his ex-professional athletes that are in the marijuana investment business?
Not
he
in Texas.
He can open up a dispensary. I don't need to sell it in Texas. I can do it where it's legal.
That's where he was. Michael Thompson's music.
Woo-hoo.
That means that Michael Thompson is here. Good morning, Michael. How are you?
I'm doing good, boys. You know, life is always good down here in the OC.
Yes, it is. Yeah, because you don't see us.
You know, I mean, listening to talking country club, Keith. When's the last time you've been to the hood?
I was just in the hood, man. What are you talking about, Michael? What's wrong with you?
Yeah,
what's all that noise in your background? You sound like you're in an arcade or something.
No, I'm working on my doorbell. I stopped working at the house, so we're getting it fixed.
You have a doorbell?
Doesn't
everybody?
Well, when the butler's not here to answer the door.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
Do you not have a doorbell, Keith?
I don't have a doorbell.
Are you sure?
I'm positive.
Right. Of course you do. You just thought never rang a key.
So, Michael, 29 games to go in the season. What would you like to see over the final 29 games? They're the number one seed. They're playing really good basketball. What have you not seen that you would like to see over the final stretch?
Well, they've 41-12. Not much to complain about. Maybe just a little more consistency from the bench because the starters are doing a great job. And, you know, so...
Jeez,
so,
man!
Wait a minute, my IT guy was here, so I had to take care of him.
His IT guy. Oh, he's getting guy. A ring. You getting a ring,
yeah.
Michael?
He was the one fixing the doorbell.
Everybody.
Coming home. How are we feeling, guys? How excited are you for this fight?
This is
You know, in boxing, so rarely, like Pacquiao and Mayweather was 5 years too late. Even when last big heavyweight fight, real big one that the public knew about, General Tyson and Lennox Lewis, Mike was old. He was past his prime. These two dudes are the two best heavyweights in the world, in their primes, both undefeated, both with a claim to the championship, and they're coming off a great fight. In the first fight, it's a rematch of a great fight that ended in a controversial draw. For me, I mean, it doesn't get better.
For me personally, because obviously Max doing a great job covering the fight and all of that stuff, he looks at it more scientifically. For me, comes down to two things. Number one, we know the knockout power of Deontay Wilder, but we know, at least thus far in his career, Max, he's an inferior boxer to Tyson Fury. And in Tyson Fury's case, do you have the power to go with your boxing skills to take out?
We'll change trainers to work on that.
We're going
to
spend a lot of time on the fight, but first let's get to some news in the NBA, gentlemen. About 4 hours away out there in L.A., the battle of the city races towards the playoffs.
Speaking
LeBron,
of heavyweights.
Right, has his Lakers in the top spot in the West. Meanwhile, Kawhi and the Clippers have added pieces to improve their roster of depth, a fact that's not lost on Lakers legend Magic Johnson. The former president of basketball operations for the Lakers told USA Today, if you look at man for man, the Clippers are probably better than the Lakers in terms of bench. But to Anthony Davis and LeBron James, to me, they're going to be the key, and they're going to have to dominate in that series. Then we're going to need that third score. Stephen A., would the Lakers be better off having Magic in charge?
I definitely think that's the case, and I mean no disrespect whatsoever to Rob Pelinka. At the beginning of the season, we raved about the job that Rob Pelinka had done in light of the fact that Magic Johnson had left at the last day of the regular season so abruptly last year. But the reality is that Anthony Davis was always coming to L.A.
Man, you sound fucking stupid.
That had a lot to do with Magic Johnson. Kyle Kuzma.
Stephen A. sounds fucking stupid.
So the question is the other parts, supplementary parts that you need in order to win a championship. Darren Collison coming out of retirement.
What?
Clears waivers and all of that stuff after departing and being bought out from the Detroit Pistons. The question that you
This is exactly why I stopped listening to fucking First Take.
Magic Johnson had been able to pull off something like that.
Shut up. Shut up. Sounds stupid.
Strip the Astros of their title, and you can't suspend any of their players. What should their punishment be?
Well, if you can't do that, then what's the point? I mean, you got to leave it alone if you can't strip their title. You can let the players keep their ring, but since they were so cheating so blatantly and so illegally, just declare the trophy vacant, send the trophy back. The players can keep their ring, But every time they look at those rings, they'll know they have an asterisk next to them, and they really are not valid. So let them keep their rings. I wouldn't ask them to turn them in.
What's up, family?
Fuck, I wanted Opal, man. Look what I got. That's tough.
street. I.e. NBA Youngboy. Once the label has done what they want to do with the artist,
right,
they put that call in.
Come get this motherfucker.
Now, all of a sudden, fucking old cases start popping up and all this good shit right here. They can pull you off the street. That's a requirement. We have to be able to pull you off the street at any fucking time. Once we realize that you've run your course, Bobby Smurda, TK, YNW Melly, XXXTentacion, these are all good examples of an artist running their course. And before they get to be that salty, bitter artist doing the Rich the Kid shit, the Tory Lanez shit, where they call out the fucking label but not, you know, y'all ain't doing enough for me and all this shit like this. Pull this motherfucker off the street so we got more to worry about than fucking how his music ain't being promoted like it was when it first came out. I think a very good example of someone who escaped it, but you get to see what the escape looks like. The prices to promote on this show for artists are $200. For small business owners, $100. Do not contact me until you're ready to make a transaction. I've been saying this for a year and a half now. Do not send me a video, a song, anything of you until you are ready for promotion, meaning you have money in hand. It's obvious you want me to promote you, but you don't want to spend the money, and that's why you are where you are. That social media sponsorship bullshit doesn't work. You can spend $25. But nothing happens. You niggas will spend $25 a million times instead of paying $500 one time and get some real promotion. Nobody watches local artists. When they see a sponsored video, they scroll past it. So why would you think that they have a viable promotion? Because it's cheap and you don't know what the fuck you're doing. But you don't even want to pay that person to tell you what you need to do. But you know you don't know what you're doing because you've been failing for this long. It is what it is. For all my YouTubers also that are doing the wrong shit and you're trying to get on the right track, we have YouTube classes. They cost $550 for the whole class. But the first session is $250, the last two sessions are $150, and the end you know, we monetize. Of course, it's gonna be a whole class in one day. It's just you learn how to do your thumbnails, tag, title, all that shit like that, and your algorithm, how to get in the system. But if you want that, hit me up in any one of the contacts that I have. We'll get started on that also. Get that boy. Pull up in the street. They ain't here. What the fuck? And it's a shame I can't even remember this nigga's name. If, boy, as hot as that song was, nigga can't even remember the motherfucker name, man. I would say designer. I can say designer. But motherfuckers like that who have a song and the song is bigger than the artist. So, what a label will do instead of having to deal with the artist for all this time and you know all this shit right here. Look, I'm gonna pull this goddamn, I'm gonna get his ass off the street. Put something else on his mind so he can't worry about how the fuck we rob him. And on top of that, we're gonna get an influx in sales because everybody likes an incarcerated rapper when they first get incarcerated. Everybody likes a dead rapper when they first get killed. So sales go through the fucking roof and we've seen it time and time again. The biggest part of this whole trap, this whole system, in order for it to work, the artist has to understand that if they don't put their life and their freedom in danger at every turn,
woo,
they're gonna flop. It's over with. At every turn,
Come on. What? Shit, let's go. I see you, Zach. Shit. Damn, Porzingis killing you, though. Alright, we gotta do something about that.
They used to love when you be on that bitch smoking big blush, putting that fine
And one. Oh my God. Shit.
Your peers are all the people that have been through the industry before you. Instead of you niggas trying to pick up games where these other rap niggas been fucked up at, y'all nigga, fuck that shit.
Thank you. shit. Come on, man. Good shit, Bridges.
We want to see a nigga get fucked over so we can go right to the next nigga. Well, you don't understand how much niggas.
Good shot. I already knew it. Fuck. Shit.
Well, we don't.
no longer cool and just wait till this cool shit falls over. Like, young boy has to be with this punk nigga fucking got pounce in his bitch, got sludge in his mother. He has to do that in order for this shit not to fall down and everybody start pointing out his fucking bones.
do a music video, you gotta get high because you gotta deal with motherfuckers that you don't wanna deal with. These niggas, look at the security guard in the video. That motherfucker looks so nervous, like these little retarded motherfuckers. God, I don't know what the fuck going on. But it is what it is. Like I said, everybody has to learn their lesson. As far as the rap traffic keeps moving forward, until someone that's actually inside comes on the show and lets it be known, we can't have no, oh, shout out to Crazy Bone. A lot of folks been sending me his shit like, man, he's talking about the rap traffic. Absolutely. But we need somebody that's in the industry right now, to say, this is what this is. And more people, like, we have too many fucking great black artists, great black minds behind the scenes for us not to have. We should have a black label big as Epic, Atlantic, all right? We should be at the tops of those fucking labels. At the very tops. Like, how the fuck do we not have, you know, man,
tolerated amongst today's society. Today, we're going to explore an example of this phenomenon. Welcome to The Rap Trap, hosted by Ayo Canseco.
Pull a wig out where you heard it. Knock a bitch down in my hair mace. Bag rich business, I wear that. Eat a fiends of blunt, let them shed it. Show the chopper to your crib, then tear that. I can send a loan, tell me where it. But have the money neat though. I'm bagging up some more thought with gringos. When you hit my phone, use the lingo. Money all around like casinos. Trap house jumping like
Philly. Welcome back to The Rap Trap. I'm El Canseco. This is In Hindsight. Let's get straight to it. I just told you, motherfucker, what was going on. 2 weeks ago, I sat in this very same spot and told you we're due for a major rapper to be murdered. And once again, my words went unheeded. As if I'm some type of fucking insane person. As if I haven't been telling you what the fuck been going on since I touched down on this motherfucker. There's a lot of things we're gonna talk about tonight. A lot of things we're gonna talk about. Pop Smoke is dead. Another rapper, young rapper, he fit the age.
Bullshit. That's some, you know, I go spiritual, you know, when I